In the United States, 3 safe and efficacious COVID-19 vaccinations are available: Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson. In a nutshell, these immunizations save lives. They are an important piece of the jigsaw in preventing the spread of new variations and ensuring that COVID-19 is no longer a pandemic that threatens the lives of people in our community and throughout the world. Today, we are counting down the top 10 myths on COVID-19 vaccination. So let's take a view. Before we get started, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring that bell to get notified about our latest videos. Number 10, the vaccines can lead to long-term effects. With vaccinations, if there is going to be a consequence or adverse effect, like an allergic response, for example, it will happen within minutes to hours. Dr. Cunningham explains, if we're not seeing major adverse effects right now, we can very much be sure it'll be safe in the long run. Furthermore, while the COVID-19 vaccines are new, the mRNA technology utilized to make them has been applied for decades in cancer, influenza, Zika, and rabies therapies. This experience has shown us that unanticipated, delayed side effects appear within 2 months of taking the vaccination. Since the first vaccine studies over a year ago, these vaccines have been in use for several months. There are no long-term negative consequences to be concerned about. Number 9. Vaccine was developed too quickly without proper research and is not safe. All COVID-19 vaccinations are subject to extensive safeguards to assure their safety. COVID-19 vaccines must undergo extensive testing in clinical trials before getting WHO and National Regulatory Agency approval. This is to ensure they fulfill globally agreed upon safety and efficacy standards. COVID-19 vaccine research, development, and authorizations were accomplished in record time, meeting the urgent demand for COVID-19 vaccinations while maintaining high safety standards due to unprecedented scientific partnerships. WHO and regulatory agencies will continue to monitor COVID-19 vaccine consumption equally they do with other vaccines to ensure that it is safe for everyone who receives it. Number 8. The Astra Zeneca vaccine is dangerous. The World Health Organization's Global Advisory Committee on Vaccine Safety, WHO-GACVS, has determined that the AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccine, Vaxzevria and Covishield, is effective in avoiding significant COVID-19 infection adverse effects that can result in hospitalization and death. The vaccine's most common adverse effects are mild to severe and typically go away after a few days. The most severe side effects are uncommon, although they might result in blood clots due to low platelet count. According to recent data from the United Kingdom, there are about 4 incidents of major adverse effects per million individuals who take the vaccination. According to the WHO-GACVS, the advantages of vaccination greatly outweigh the danger of rare adverse effects. Number 7. If I'm pregnant or breastfeeding, I shouldn't get vaccinated. Vaccination is safe to get at any stage of pregnancy or during breastfeeding. You might, theoretically, transfer protective COVID-19 antibodies to the baby if you are vaccinated during your third trimester, adds Dr. Cunningham, but it's safe to get vaccinated at any stage of pregnancy. Moreover, breastfeeding women who have received COVID-19 mRNA vaccinations have antibodies in their breast milk, which may help protect their newborns from COVID-19. Number 6. Young and healthy people don't need to get vaccinated. While young, healthy people are less prone to become ill than older people, COVID-19 has put them in the ICU. Even if they are asymptomatic, people may experience long-term effects months after the virus has exited their system. They can also unwittingly spread COVID-19 to individuals who are more vulnerable, putting loved ones at risk of becoming gravely ill. Getting everyone vaccinated, not just the most susceptible, Dr. Cunningham adds, is the key to stopping the pandemic. Number 5. Natural immunity, immunity after natural infection, is better than vaccine immunity. Vaccines assist your body to develop immunity without the negative side effects that illnesses might cause. COVID-19 has the potential to cause major problems and even death. COVID-19 does not have a particular therapy. It is significantly more rational to avoid the danger. Number 4. People with underlying conditions shouldn't get vaccinated. People with underlying diseases such as diabetes and heart disease are at higher risk of COVID-19 problems, which is all the more reasons to get vaccinated, according to Dr. Cunningham. If you have any concerns, speak with a doctor who is assisting you in control of your disease. Number 3. COVID-19 vaccines can compromise your fertility. According to the WHO, whether you are trying to conceive right now or in the future, you should acquire a COVID-19 vaccination as soon as one becomes available. There is presently no indication that the COVID-19 vaccine affects any issues during pregnancy, including placental development. Furthermore, there is no proof that any vaccine, including COVID-19 immunizations, cause reproductive difficulties. COVID-19 vaccinations are now being studied for adverse effects, as are other vaccines, and will continue to be studied for many years. Of course, you should always get medical advice before making any of these decisions. Number 2. You can get COVID-19 from the vaccines. The vaccinations don't contain any live virus, so they can't infect you, adds Dr. Cunningham. In essence, immunizations cause our bodies to create a single viral protein, the protein that infects our cells. We prevent infection by producing that protein. You may have side effects like as a headache or chills, but this is due to your body's immune reaction rather than an infection. Number 1. If you already had COVID-19, you do not need to be vaccinated. Even if you've previously had COVID-19, the World Health Organization recommends that you be vaccinated. The level of protection provided by COVID-19 varies from person to person, and it's unclear how long natural immunity will continue. COVID-19 vaccine is still recommended for those who have already been infected with COVID-19. So guys, that was it for this video. What did you think about our video? Let us know in the comment section below. If you are new to our channel, be sure to subscribe and ring that notification bell to get notified about our latest videos. Thank you for watching. We'll be right back.